creepy box with like
the Ouija board. It's enchanted generations. And not a lot of people know this, but it was first made in Baltimore in the late 1800s by brothers William and Isaac Fuld.
This was my grandfather's an Oriole board.
Baltimore is celebrating the best-selling board with a special exhibition and presentation at the Museum of Industry. Scores of collectors and three generations of the Fuld family turned out for the show, but not everyone was a Ouija fan.
My best friend and I attempted to do it one time. I was in 7th or 8th grade, and we wanted to do it the right way. You don't touch it. The planchette actually moved on its own, and I said, that's it, forget it, and I wouldn't do it. They spook me!
So how does it work?
We have psychics who believe what's really happening is a form of telepathy. If you believe there are demons or spirits out there, then there are these influences are coming through you, coming through the board and answering your questions. And then you also have psychologists who believe in ideomotor response, which is your subconscious is actually answering the questions. You are pushing the planchette, the message indicator. You just don't know it. Scientists believe it's just an elaborate hoax.
What's not a hoax is the craftsmanship that went into making the boards on display at the Museum of Industry. Some fetch thousands of dollars. All of them are steeped in history and mystery. From the Baltimore Museum of Industry, I'm Karen Zeitvogel for CNS TV. One of the early investors who